Welcome to the backstage of Arthur Abessa Collection Autumn Winter 2021. Hello, Arthur.
Hello, Charity, Antonia, and Guy. So lovely to see you.
So lovely to have you again. This is wonderful at the backstage. Again, very, very strong backstage backdrop for this amazing collection. Would you just like to share with us your ideas?
So yeah, as you know, as a small brand, you always have to find a sort of creative show space, a creative venue. For me, this is very important that when you come to the show, you get a sort of like full experience. You don't just come to like a room, see clothes and leave again. I want that the music, the location, the people, the models, the hair, the makeup, everything tells you a story. My story this season is about Milan. I have so much taken so much inspiration from Vienna lately, from my city of origin, but I live in Milan for 15 years. And so this season was about Milan, its architecture, its sort of like facades, its colors as well.
Yes.
Also its people. I have a few Milanese friends walking the show. There's a curator, there's a designer, there's like people that inspire me and that like my clothes. And I think it's very important for us designers as well to create a network, to create a circle of friends, to create support, to create love. Also the support like the Tony and Guy and you have always given me. This is all very, very important. That a brand can grow, a brand can survive these days as well. So the inspiration was Milan architecture. I also collaborated with my friend Marco Guazzini. He's a designer and invented an incredible material called Marvulus.
Okay.
It is made out of marble dust and wool fiber, and he created this beautiful sort of like plates where he where this is like marble and wool, and we use the same mohair wool in our knits in some of the jumpers, and we also took a photographic print of a big plate that he produced and turned it into sort of like all over prints.
Yes.
And then we did some jewelry as well with it. We did buttons on some of the jackets out of the material, and this is a very direct sort of collaboration with a designer based in Milan and another designer based in Milan, and I think this is great.
This is wonderful because it shows that you want to create creative synergy, you're not afraid to shine together, and it's also innovative.
Yes, because as we all know, one is stronger than alone. And also it's also about a positive experience. It's so nice when you inspire each, when one inspires the other, when there is a conversation, when there is, because every conversation, every project opens a new project, opens a new experience, opens new contacts. And I think this is all really important. It's sometimes good not only to think dress, business, sales, it's also important to think a human touch, and I think this is very important now.
Yeah. So what would you say if there's one word to describe the Arthur Abessa collection in Milan this season, what would be that one word to describe?
I would call it, it's two words, but I would call it Milanese friendship. My friends in Milan, it's about the love that the city has given me and this inspiration that the city has given me. So it's a Milanese friendship.
Wonderful, Arthur. Every season I see innovation. Every season I see the same old good values. And you know, I can't wait to see the amazing show.
So
stay tuned, everybody.
Support. Thanks, Tony and Guy. Thank you, Charity.
Welcome to Milan Fashion Week Arthur Abessa for Winter 2020. Here we are with James as well as Ryan from Tony and Guy. So James, it's a great pleasure to have you in Milan. I'm really excited. Would you just share with us what has been the inspiration in creating this hair look for Arthur Abessa?
Yeah, so I mean, it's a super fun show. Last night, Ryan and I went to the hair test and we were... Before the bar.
Yeah.
No bar for me right now. I've been, it's been long days, but yeah, maybe tonight. But what we did was we were taking a look at the collection, and there was a lot of this mohair in the sweaters that he wanted to incorporate into the hair some way, which I thought was an interesting idea. And he also talked about creating a really clean silhouette around the face, tight to the head, covering the ears. And so we wanted to marry those two things together. And so it's really easy when you start pulling the hair down like that. It can go library, really, like librarian. So by adding a little bit of cool texture on the top, it like elevates it a little bit.
Yeah. So. And was it fun? Was it easy at the backstage yesterday? Was it easy at the hair test that you guys got the look immediately, or there was a little bit of that?
Yeah, it was fun.
It was cool. It was nice.
Yeah, Ryan was like showing me some new stuff with the product, which I thought was cool. kind of playing with different ideas of things that we can do, and it's hard in the test. Sometimes you want to try to figure out the look, and you don't want to back yourself into a corner with your product that you're using. So a lot of times I tend to stay with some drier textures first off, so we don't have to wash the girl's hair. And then we can kind of figure out the look. And then at the end, we decided maybe it would be really good to use a little bit of the protein cream.
Yeah,
so just to like,
yeah.
Well, so the idea is to have the hair it has like a layer of dryness to the top, like a little bit of a fuzz.
So how do we prep it?
Well, we're gonna prep the hair first by just going through with the volume mousse. We're doing roots to ends, and we're blow drying everything super flat down with a center parting. Then we take out this top section, about 2 centimeters on each side of the parting, and we're gonna back comb that. And we're gonna just put a light mist of hairspray on it, and then we just kind of tap it with the flat iron, and we're setting the hair to almost like a crimping style. We're gonna let that cool down. And then this is kind of like something I'm always like into, is like playing with dust. So the resurrection dust, we're just putting it over the ear section, adding a little bit of a back comb, and that is pulled over the ears. And by adding the dust there, it kind of creates more like a webbing, so it can cover the ears and it doesn't slip. We pull that into a low ponytail. We brush out the top section that we flat iron. So now there's a bit of a crimp to it. We pull that over the top of that into the ponytail. And then we finish off the ponytail by just doing a really classic rope braid.
Sounds really interesting. There are different looks of different models. Some are shorter hair. So how did you guys play with the texture, or was there a variation to the look?
So I think what makes shows more modern today is we're not creating clones. So it's more challenging for hairdressers like us, because now we're looking at people's hair and we have to adjust it a little bit. Like, you know, if some hair textures need things, different products than others. And also the style, we have to adjust it for a different haircut. So with some of the girls that have more of a bob shape, what we're doing is we're straightening out the hair, and then we're still doing that layer over the top, but then we just lay it over it, and we just mist it with some hairspray.
Label M hairspray, obviously. Okay, good. And Ryan, this is the first time our team, Turning Artistic Team, worked together with James. You know, how has it been at the backstage show for us?
You know what? We work with a lot of international artists, like a lot. And I gotta say, to see him in his reasoning process backstage yesterday, and how he's able to just pick the right look at the right time. I mean, I personally think that working with him has just been exceptional, because he's zen. He's completely cool. He makes people feel at ease, and he made our team feel completely at home, and you know, lets everyone work on the hair. And I think it's just a great opportunity for people to grow, you know.
Yeah.
No, it's a pleasure. I mean, we get to travel around. The people that are getting to work backstage is the best hairdressers in the world. It's cool to meet some new people, and this should be fun. We're supposed to have fun, so.
Thank you, James. I'm really, really happy to have you in our team this time. You know, thank you so much. And it's been really a good pleasure and a great vibe at the backstage. Can't wait to see the show.